Hello everyone, and welcome to the October 2025 Sky Report. My name is Vanessa, and I'm joined today by Patrick.
Hello everyone.
Let's see what's happening in the skies this month.
Our first highlight this month is the final Titan shadow transit on October 5th. This event is more difficult to observe as Titan's shadow just grazes Saturn's northern polar region. The transit begins at 9:18 p.m., but the shadow becomes noticeable around 9:45 p.m. An 8-inch telescope at 200 magnification or a 10-inch telescope at 250 magnification should provide a good view of Titan's shadow, especially under excellent atmospheric conditions. At 10:30 p.m., Titan's shadow reaches its midpoint. This is the best chance to observe it. During the entire event, Titan remains positioned in front of Saturn. The Titan shadow transit ends around 11:30 p.m. as Titan moves off Saturn's face. This marks the end of the rare Titan shadow transit event for 2025. The next season of Titan shadow transits will take place in 2040.
On October 6th, the moon will appear slightly bigger than usual in what has been called a supermoon. A supermoon happens when the moon reaches a close point in its orbit during the full phase. On October 6th, the moon will be 356,270 kilometers away. Though you may hear that the moon appears larger during a supermoon, it is difficult to notice the difference between a supermoon and a regular moon. The moon on this day will be only about 14% bigger than the moon on its smallest day. Without seeing them next to each other, it's difficult to tell the difference. If you want to measure the difference in size yourself, see the activity from JPL linked below. On October 9th, the moon will pass in front of the bright star cluster, the Pleiades. The bright star in the cluster, Electra, will already be covered by the time the moon rises around 8:30 p.m. An hour later at 9:30 p.m., the bright star towards the center of the cluster, Alcyone, is covered by the moon. By 10:30 p.m., the bright stars of the Pleiades have returned and the event is over. This will be visible without a telescope, although it may be difficult to see the bright stars of the Pleiades due to the glare of the moon. Binoculars will provide the best view.
The Orionid meteor shower peaks on the morning of October 21st. The meteor shower occurs when the Earth moves through the debris field left by Halley's Comet. Under perfect conditions, 20 meteors per hour are expected. While the number of meteors per hour is modest, the new moon will allow dark skies for excellent viewing. As we look to the east, the constellations of the early winter begin to rise above the horizon. The bright yellowish star Capella in Auriga leads the way, accompanied by the Pleiades star cluster. Just below them, the reddish star Aldebaran in Taurus the Bull follows closely behind. Higher up, the constellations Perseus and Aries ascend into the early autumn sky. To the west, the stars of the summer triangle, Deneb, Altair, and Vega, move westward each night. By 4 a.m., the summer triangle has already set.
To the south, we lost most of our bright stars, but we still have the planet Saturn shining bright between Aquarius and Pisces. The constellation Pegasus is one of the most recognizable constellations out, with a large square nearly overhead. The bright star Fomalhaut sits low on the horizon. We also see Sagittarius setting in the southeast.
Jupiter rises in the east after midnight at the beginning of the month. On the 1st, it appears at 12:44 a.m., and by the 31st, it rises earlier at 10:54 p.m. It can be found in the constellation Gemini, just beneath the twin stars Castor and Pollux. Saturn shines high in the southern sky an hour before midnight in the middle of the month. It lies in the faint constellation Pisces, directly below the square of Pegasus.
Venus is up early in the morning this month, starting in the constellation of Leo, low on the horizon at 6 a.m. In the middle of the month, by 6 a.m., Venus has moved lower on the horizon towards the constellation of Virgo. And by the end of the month at the same time, Venus is low on the horizon, still in the constellation of Virgo as it makes its way back towards the Sun. And here is your lunar calendar for the month. The full moon is on the 6th, the last quarter is on the 13th, the new moon is on the 21st, and the first quarter is on the 29th.
Thank you so much for joining us for October, and we'll see you again next month.
Bye.